Okay, I will start. It's a joint work with my colleague Jeremy Chalotin and Damiano Sarda. Damian is working in geometric group theory, and we used his competences in topology. And it's about topological characterization of basis graphs of matroids. And the follow-up of this was a research also done together with Jeremy and Damian and Hiroshi Hirai. And this invitation of Hirai and myself to this conference was an opportunity to meet 1 week before and work well together, all four. So this is it's a separate session of. Okay, and everybody knows what a matroid is, and I will recall B is a family of subset of a finite set. Well, a cardinal satisfying the exchange axiom is that for any two sets A and B, and any element A in A minus B, there exists an element B in B minus A such that A minus A union B is a bais. So that the set of B are called bases. All they have the same cardinality, and the basis graph G of B has the set of bases as vertices, and two bases are adjacent if and only if they differ by a simple exchange, if and only if the symmetric difference is 2. In fact, the basis graph represents the matroids. Two matroids having this isomorphic basis graphs are isomorphic up to relabeling of elements of the ground set. And also, the basis graph of the matroid is a one skeleton of the matroid polyhedron, the convex hull of the bases in Euclidean space. And even it characterizes. There is Gelfand, another characterization that essentially from character. But OK, I have not. Many open questions are formulated on basis graph, say the symmetric exchange problem or J. Whether basis graph are expanders is a big question. And now I will recall the basis graph characterization by Stefan Maurer, because our result concern answering his questions and is related to this characterization. And Maurer in '73 characterizes basis graphs in the following way. A finite graph is G is a basis graph of a matroid if and only if it satisfies three conditions. I will name them and then we define them. If and only G satisfies interval link condition. These are our names. Link condition. Interval condition. Interval condition. And positioning condition. So what is the link condition? The link condition is say that if you take any base and you take the its neighborhood, close neighborhood, this is N of B in the basis graph, then this one, we call this is a link because it's a link actually, or neighborhood. This is a line graph of a bipartite graph. So the neighborhoods are isomorphic to line graph or bipartite graphs. So this link condition, N of B is a line graph of a bipartite graph. One can easily see why. Because essentially, if you take any base, you put in one side of the biparted graph B. On another side, you put all the elements which are not in B, but are presented in the neighboring bases. And just the edge here give you a swap from one side, or from the side of B to another side. And actually, one can show that the neighborhood here is just intersection of edges. From edge. So it's a line graph. OK. And also is useful for Maurer to encoding. When he have a graph satisfying those three conditions, starting encoding, because you need to encode the vertices of that graph, abstract graph, by basis of some matroid. And starting the encoding is just using the line graph. You start with one part will be of the line graph will be one base, and then the neighborhood you expand using edges, etc. OK, what is the interval condition? If you take two bases at distance 2, this means that they differ in 4 elements, then you have and you consider the common neighborhoods of these two bases, then you have only 3 possibilities in matroids. Either they form a square with two bases. This is because of the exchange property. Always you have a square. But you don't have many possibilities to go from B to B prime via neighborhoods, because just 4. So either we have a pyramid, so we have such a B prime, or we have an octahedron. This is B prime. This is the interval condition. And the last is a global. These two conditions are local, just concern neighborhoods or two neighborhoods of bases. And the third condition is a positioning condition. Is how the squares in the basis graph lie with respect to the leveling of the graph from the base point, from an arbitrary base point. And this is just, you take a base, B0, and you split the graph into spheres. So all points are distance 1, distance 2, 3, etc. Now you have a square. And the square cannot be arbitrarily stay. And this is also a consequence of the exchange property. That the square can be either in 3 levels, in 1 level, or in 2 levels, in this way. So what is impossible that you have such thing or symmetric one. OK. And you have a square which is this way. This is impossible. And this is possible. And in his paper, he formulated 3 conjectures. Two of them are related with our results. Is first, he was asking about redundancy in his characterization. First, he asked whether this condition is redundant. It was important in his proof. And our first result, indeed, it is redundant. So it's. Oops. So, theorem 1. Oh, theorem 1. Else is redundant. Okay, I will not prove this. It's more about the second question of Maurer. And the second one is replacing this position by a this condition by a topological one, and namely. He defined, and this is used, for example, in the Bjorner survey topological method in combinatorics. He defined a complex on a basis graph. So the complex, so we, if a triangle we call now triangle squared complex, triangle square complex. So I will define it, denote it in this way, but one can also of G. Just you define a cell complex, two-dimensional cell complex, where the faces are either triangles in the graph or the squares, induced squares. So you fill the triangles with solid triangles and the square with solid squares. And you get something, a two-dimensional surface, which is very complicated. If you take the matroid polyhedron and you take all two-dimensional faces, they are not exactly is a subset of such complex. The two-dimensional subcomplex of the matroid polyhedron is a subcomplex of this, because there are some redundant squares, but we put in them. And he asked whether positioning condition can be replaced plus by simple connectivity of this complex. I will explain simple connectivity of X of G, G of V. And essentially, this is wrong. It was found in 77 and also by Maurer himself, but it's almost true. And we'll explain what the result is. And then I will explain what simple connectivity is and the method of proof. And so our theorem is as follows. Theorem for graph G, the following conditions are equivalent. First, G is a basis graph of a matroid. Two, X of G, triangle square complex of G, is simply connected. And any ball of radius 3 is like in a matroid, and any ball of radius at most 3 of G is like in a matroid. And 3, just we specify this a little bit, is essentially G has a vertex of finite degree. Because this graph is not necessarily finite, but this will be finite. The graph satisfying this will be finite, actually, of finite degree. X of G is simply connected, and G satisfies interval condition and local positioning condition. Local positioning condition is just the positioning condition just very local at the distance 3 from the base point. So you see this is a local characterization. Say that if you have a triangle square complex, if you have a graph and you take its triangle square complex, and this triangle square complex is simply connected, and you look locally at each neighborhood radius 3, and this is like in a matroid, then this is a matroid. Such theorems are quite a lot in continuous mathematics. For example, spaces of non-positive curvature are characterized a little bit in this way. They are globally of non-positive curvature if and only if they are simply connected, and locally they are good. Also spheres, Maurer's, there is one that you can characterize the spheres by some curvature condition and simple connectivity. And there is a famous now Gromov combinatorial characterization of cut zero cubical complexes, which are median graphs. One skeletons are exactly the median graphs, You see, the same objects occur in different areas, discrete mathematics, but also in continuous mathematics. He characterized them like simply connected cube complexes, which are locally good. And locally good, there is kind of a link condition. So I will not go there, but it's of the same type. And actually, we were working before on this kind of characterization. And when we now about this Maurer paper and question, and then this way we come to investigate a small change in his wrong conjecture, which is now one can to say is true. Okay, do you have any questions about this? So it's okay. Or now I will explain why, what is simple connectivity and how we prove the result. And please stop me when. Is good for this? No, no, it's okay, it's okay, it's okay. This is. So the chairman is to get honor, not to clean the blackboard. I have to do it myself. Okay. Okay, thank you. It's okay, it's okay. No, no, don't. Okay, thank you. Okay, what is simple connectivity? It's the next step of one connectivity, which is connectivity, usual connectivity. It's essentially the following, that you have a space, and it is simply connected if for any loop, any curve or cycle, if you draw the cycle, usual cycle, and you put have a isomorphic map to this curve, cycle C, then this map can be extended to a continuous map from the ball, from the disk, two-dimensional disk, to the complex. So you can fill the loops. This means that any cycle is contractible in the space. And since we deal with complexes, which consist of triangles and squares, this definition can be reformulated in the following way. If you have a cycle in the graph, then all the time either you have three consecutive vertices which are adjacent in the graph. This is a triangle move. Or you have three adjacent vertices which these two which live in a square. And this way you can homotop to the single point. Yeah, this means this is combinatorial definition, so there is no mystery. what happened that if you go from connectivity is the most simplest thing we think. Simple connectivity is difficult, is undecidable whether a finite simplicial complex is simply connected. It's but say for example in our case from the proof it follows a polynomial algorithm to decide. Okay, this is the definition, and now about the proof, idea of the proof. So we are using a universal cover, which is a very nice object. So we have a cell. Suppose that you have a triangle cell complex, and you have another one. And the map from this is X and this is Y, and the map from Y to X is a covering map. If for any vertex key, this is a cell-to-cell surjective map. It maps triangles to triangles and square to squares. Yeah, it doesn't contract things. And now, if you take any vertex and you take the star of this vertex, the star of the vertex is the union of all cells containing it. And you take its image, f of v. The image, the star of the image will be isomorphic to the star of v. So it is locally isomorphic. Yeah. This is a covering map. And one very nice thing is that, if you have here simply connected space, simply connected, and you have a covering map from this y to x, and you have another simply connected space y prime, and you have a covering map to x, that they are equal. If you require that you covering map is simply is from the simply connected space, then this is a unique space, and this is called universal cover. Universal cover. And we'll build this universal cover step by step. In fact, just to give in graphs are unidimensional complexes. And the universal covers of graphs are infinite trees. Just what is the universal cover as a complex of a pentagon? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This will be an infinite path where vertex 1 will have neighbors 2, 5. 5 will have neighbor 4. 4 have neighbor 3. 3 will have 2. 2 will have 1, etc. This is the universal cover of a cycle. If you take Peterson graph, the universal cover will be a ternary tree, but infinite. If your initial space is simply connected, then the universal cover is already the space itself. Okay, so we will build this universal cover step by step. Actually, we will prove what is the idea behind. This is like producing movies. You want to show the reality, you don't touch the reality, you film your movie and prove properties about your movie and claim that this is a reality. Okay, in fact, you need to prove the map to the reality. And we prove it. This is theory. We can do such maps. And we build our covering map step by step, we can prove properties about it and prove global properties, and global properties are this positioning condition of Maurer. Okay, so I now explain the proof. So we start with the graph G, for which satisfy this interval condition, local positioning condition. But we don't assume that X of G is simply connected. We don't assume that. If it is simply connected, then what we will build, we'll just build G. It happened. We'll prove that. But if it is not simply connected, we will build something else which will be finite and will be the universal cover of the triangle square complex of G. Okay, how we will do? We have G here, and here we will build the universal cover. We start with a vertex V and take the star of this vertex and just take it copy here, and take the identity map from this to this. This is the first level, and this is we'll have this S0, and this will be tilde. But we put a tilde on all points, vertices, and etc. We'll put tilde. And here, this will be S1 tilde. This one will be S1 tilde. And this is a good map. And now we want to expand this map. So suppose that after many steps, we have built V tilde, first level, second level. So we S1 tilde, this is S0 tilde, S1 tilde, S2 tilde, etc. And so we have built SI tilde. We denote BI tilde, the union of SI tilde. We also have GI tilde will be a graph defined here. I will show how we will define it. Whose vertex set is BI tilde. And we define the XI tilde is just the triangle square complex of GI tilde. And we build a map FI tilde, FI, from XI tilde to X, X of G. And now we want to expand this map so that it will, at the end, what we want. We will take the union of such maps, which are just increasing. And we will show that this union is a covering map. And what we built here is a universal cover. Because it is, we'll show that this space we'll be built here is simply connected. So our map is this. We have FI. And now we need this next level. And to define, so we want to, we also suppose that this is like linear, not linear programming, dynamic programming. You to prove something, to solve some sub-problem, you need many, many other sub-problems. We require many, many properties to get just one at the end. And we will prove that they are satisfied. I will not formulate what are the conditions we require, but and okay, now I want to build SI plus one tilde. How to do this? First, we define the pairs W tilde Z, which are W tilde is a vertex in SI tilde, and Z, what is Z? I will show what is Z. So I have a W here, tilde. By this map FI, W has some image, has an image. This is W. Also, W tilde has his neighborhood, has his neighborhood here, neighbors. All such neighbors are mapped here. Yeah, they have the they have images. But they will also be adjacent to W. But it may be that W has a neighbor Z, which doesn't have yet, which is not an image of somebody. We have this way we discover vertices. Yeah. So that Z will be vertices which are in the neighborhood of the image of W tilde, in the neighborhood of the W tilde, but which are not, sorry, which are neighborhood of the image of W tilde, here, this one W, but they are not in the image of the neighborhood of W tilde. So I can write this, but this is the definition. Okay? This is a definition of W. And now, you imagine that this Z can have other neighbor, W prime, which is the image of somebody else here, W prime tilde. So you have this, and this is like I will build something W tilde Z, and we will build, no, sorry, this is W prime tilde Z. But I have to identify them. You have many dangling edges, three edges. In the next level, which are essentially should have the same extremity, the same endpoint. And how to define, therefore we define equivalence class relation, the term that it is equivalence class. So we define the relationship between two, we say that they are equivalent if and only if z equals z prime. And one of the conditions we have, and this is the essential step how we define the three conditions which allow us to identify the vertices. We have z1, z2, z3. And this is essentially that, one is the images. I will denote without tilde the images. W are adjacent to W prime. So W and W prime tilde have the same adjacent images, or identical images. This is one condition. Second condition is that there exists a neighbor. They have a common neighbor in the level before, U tilde, so that this U tilde, together with the images of these two and Z, form a square. So there exists U tilde adjacent to W tilde, W prime tilde, such that F of U, F of W, F of W prime, Z is a square, And this third condition is essentially the following, that W and W prime live in a square here, so which is mapped by the map Fi to a square here, so that together with Z they form a pyramid. This is the third condition. Third condition is to a pyramid. I have to stop. Okay. Okay. I will. This relation is a transitive. Therefore, it's an equivalence relation, and we make the quotient, take the equivalence classes of such relation as vertices of Si prime, Si plus 1 tilde, we define this way. And then we just define the zero skeleton, the vertices. We need the edges to define the graph, and then et cetera, the map. And we do it this way. We define the what are the edges in this graph, and then we define the map, Fi plus 1. We take the triangle square complex of this graph, and we show that this map we define is a good map to the initial graph. And this way, at the end, we get that we take the union of all Fi, and this show that this is a color, and you take the union of all Xi tilde, and G is a union of all Gi tilde. They are just included one into another one. And we prove that this is a covering map, that this one is simply connected, and this one satisfies the positioning condition with respect to the base point we started. And we do this for all base points. But since we build up the universal cover, I have to put a V, all they are isomorphic. Therefore, when we build in different way, we get the same space. We get the same result. Therefore, we prove the positioning condition for all of them. This way, we prove what we wanted. And this object is the same for all base points. OK, I finished in this way. Sorry. Sorry, Gromo? This is Mikhail, Milena Mikhail, and Sudan. Matkusudan conjecture. That is essentially is about this. That the basic graph is an expander. Yeah, for all. It is a noun for graphic matroid and for this, how it's called by, this positive correlation. There is another class extending graphic matroids, but it's not known for binary matroids. And the binary matroids are exactly the matroids for which the basis graph does not contain three octahedra. All two intervals are just squares and pyramids. This is if you partition in any two parts, the number of edges running between the parts is then the minimum of the sides. Or you, by canonical path, what I am hoping that you can prove by this canonical path argument, like the hypercube, so you can construct a family of canonical paths, shortest path, so that any edge is used in a linear number of time in the number of bases by pass. So this you also can construct a multiflow also of size one between any pair of vertices. But yeah, this is. This is two is not good at all, and in fact, the counterexample were built. You take the uniform matroid of rank n on two n elements, but n should be enough big. And you take just an automorphism on this and factorize by the classes, the vertices which are go each to another. And if you factorize, you get something which is good. Locally is good, yeah? Because anyway, it is like in this uniform matroid at radius 3. At radius 3, yeah, it's good. But what happened is that if this n is too small, this matroid is still simply connected, but doesn't satisfy this positioning, local positioning condition for 3. But if n is enough big, and this was a counterexample by Maurer, by Donald Tovey, and I forget the third, Holtzman. But if this matroid n is big, but then everything is fine. But the complex triangle square complex of that factorization will be not simply connected. This is why you need the three. Say. And
okay. Thank you once again.
Okay, thank you.